Today, let us discuss about the flux of a vector field. You know, flux, its symbol is phi. It is a property of any vector field and is a measure of the flow the field vectors through an imaginary surface placed in the field. Let us consider the example of flux of a velocity vector. Suppose these four lines you see, these four lines represents the direction of flow of liquid through a region. And this is the wire loop, rectangular wire loop. I have shown four different positions of this rectangular wire loop. In the first position, the plane of the loop is right angle to the direction of flow. So what is the flux of the velocity vector? Flux of the velocity vector is actually the volume of liquid which is flowing through this loop in 1 second. Volume of the liquid which is flowing through this loop in 1 second. If V is the velocity of flow, then volume of liquid flowing through this loop in 1 second must be equal to V into A. V is the velocity of the flow and A is the area of the loop, and V into A represent the volume of the liquid which is flowing through this loop in 1 second. This is I am talking about first figure. Now let us consider the second figure. In the second figure you see that the area or the rectangular loop is bit tilted, and when it is tilted you can understand that now less number of the lines will be crossing through the area of the loop. Now if you want to find out the number of lines which is crossing through this rectangular loop normally, then phi will be equal to B A cos theta. B A cos theta. How it will be B A cos theta? Let us understand. If you consider B is the velocity vector and A is the area vector. Area vector is always perpendicular to the area. So, in this case, this is the direction of area vector and this is the direction of velocity vector. This angle is theta. So, you can say that the flux which is passing through the area normally, that is equal to B A cos theta. You can understand this part in this way. Suppose these are the lines and this is the area. This is normal to the area. So this is the direction of area vector. This angle is theta. This is the direction of velocity vector. Now, if you draw the area which is normal to the direction of flow like this, then perpendicular to this area makes an angle theta. So, if this is A, then the area in this direction must be A cos theta. So the role of A in figure A is played by A cos theta in this figure. So what is the volume of liquid which is crossing through the area normally? That must be equal to V A cos theta. So vectorially we write it as V dot product A. If theta is equal to 0 degree, then the flux crossing through the area will be maximum, that will be V A cos 0, that is equal to V into A. If theta equal to 90 degree, then flux phi is equal to V A cos 90 degree, and that is equal to 0. You can see third figure. In the third figure, this is the direction of area vector. This is the direction of velocity vector. Angle between them is 90 degree. So in this case, you can say this is the case of theta equal to 90 degree. If theta equal to 90 degree, then what is the flux? Flux phi is equal to VA cos 90 degree, that is equal to 0. So in general, you can say that the flux of the velocity vector is given by this relation, phi equal to VA cos theta. Now, instead of velocity vector, if you consider electric field vector, then V vector is replaced by E vector. If flux of velocity vector you are writing V A cos theta, then flux of electric field vector you need to write E A cos theta. If you consider, this is the electric lines of forces. These are the electric lines of forces. And suppose any particular, any arbitrary area you are considering, some lines of forces are entering, some lines of forces entering the surface this way and leaving the surface this way. So if you consider any small element dA, then the tangent drawn to this dA, the normal to this area dA, it indicates the direction of dA vector. And at this point, if you draw a tangent, it indicates the direction of electric field vector. If theta is the angle, then you can say that flux of the electric field vector phi is equal to E dA cos theta. But here you see theta is acute angle, and for any acute angle cos theta is positive. So in this case, the elementary flux d phi equal to E dA cos theta, and this value will be positive. So flux linked with the total area, if you calculate phi, that will be equal to surface integral. This symbol is for surface integral. Surface integral E dA cos theta. Now, if you consider this side, that is flux entering the surface. See, if you consider this surface, then this side line, the electric lines of force in the left side of the surface is entering the surface, and the electric lines of force to the right side of the surface is leaving the surface. So when the flux of the lines on the right side of the surface is required, then you are getting theta as acute angle, and that flux will be positive. If you want to calculate the flux of the line which is entering the surface, in that case, the direction of electric field line will be this only, but the direction of area vector will be opposite, and in that case, the value of theta will be more than 90 degree and that flux will be negative. So one very important concept about flux is the line which enter the surface, the flux, if the line enter the surface, then the flux through that surface is negative, and if the line, electric line, leave the surface, then the flux linked with that surface should be considered as positive. In general, remember, electric flux is a measure of the number of lines of force passing through some surface held in the electric field. Now let us consider the case of a closed surface, that is a surface that is completely encloses a volume, like the surface of a balloon. The net flux through the surface is given by, if you consider, this is the surface, these are the electric lines of forces passing through this surface, passing through this surface, and it is an enclosure in the, say it is a balloon. So what will be the electric flux? What will be the electric flux? Phi E equal to surface integral E dot dA. Surface integral E dot dA. Let us now consider the plane surface of area A placed in the uniform electric field E. The normal to the surface makes an angle theta with the direction of field, and by the definition of electric flux through the surface, what we can say that we have already discussed, that is flux is equal to, I have written somewhere, Ea cos theta. Flux is equal to Ea cos theta. If it is elementary flux, then it should be written as d phi, and d phi is equal to integration E dot dA, you can write. Okay, dA is the elementary area and d phi is the flux linked with the elementary area. Sorry, this is total flux. This is total flux. Phi is equal to integration E dot dA. dA is the elementary flux. Means d phi is equal to E dot dA. What is d phi? D phi is the flux linked with the elementary area dA. But if you want the flux linked with the total area, in that case, phi will be equal to integration d phi. That is equal to integration E dot dA. Okay. So this is about electric flux. Now, let us understand the different situations. I have already explained this point for velocity vector. If electric flux, if this theta is equal to 0 degree, then the electric flux is maximum. If it is 90 degree, then electric flux is 0. And if theta is equal to 180 degree, then electric flux is negative. Now let us see what is electric flux density. Electric flux density. What is electric flux density? In an electric field, the ratio of electric flux phi E through the surface to the area A. So you can understand that electric flux density is equal to phi E by A, phi E divided by A. So what is phi E for a plane surface normal to the electric field? For a plane surface normal to the electric field, that will be equal to E A cos 0. Because if the area is normal to the electric field, then perpendicular to the area vector, this is the area vector, this direction A and this direction E. So flux phi E is equal to EA cos 0 degree, that is equal to EA. So what will be electric flux density? Electric flux density will be equal to EA divided by A, and that is equal to E. Hence, the unit of electric flux density is same as electric field. Unit of electric flux density is same as electric field. Since electric field is a vector quantity, the electric flux density is also a vector quantity. Although electric flux is a scalar quantity. So this is a very important difference between the electric flux and electric flux density. Electric flux is a scalar quantity. Why? Because it is the dot product of two vectors. But electric flux density, it is a vector quantity because it is electric field. Now, what is the unit and dimension of electric field, electric flux? Let us understand. As you know that phi E is equal to EA cos theta. So what will be the SI unit of phi E? SI unit of phi E, that will be equal to electric field, its unit is Newton per Coulomb. Area, its unit is meter square. So you can say it is Newton meter square per Coulomb. Another unit you can find out in this way, that electric field, its another unit is volt per meter. So the unit of electric flux, you can write volt per meter into meter square. So it is volt into meter. And you can calculate the dimensional formula of electric flux. If you calculate, it will be coming m l t to the power minus 2 by a t into l square. L2. And that is equal to M L3 T to the power minus 3 A to the power minus 1. This you can calculate yourself. So this is the basic concept of flux of a velocity vector. You can understand in terms of flux of a velocity vector. First, you understand what is the flux of the velocity vector. It is the quantity of liquid, or you can say it is the volume of the liquid which is flowing through a given area in 1 second. And it is given by phi equal to Va cos theta. If the velocity vector is replaced by electric field vector, then the flux of electric field vector is equal to E dot dA. So d phi is equal to E dot dA. It means that this d phi is the elementary flux which is linked with the area dA. And when total flux through the area is needed, that will be equal to integration E dot dA. And electric flux is a scalar quantity, because it is the dot product of two vectors, and we know that the dot product of two vectors is always a scalar quantity. Then we have discussed the electric flux through any enclosure. Through any enclosure, some electric lines of forces will enter and some electric lines of forces will exit. Okay. So what is the total flux? Total flux phi E equal to surface integral of E dot dA. If you consider the electric flux for theta is equal to 0 degree, then the flux will be E
dA cos 0 degree, that is eDA. If theta is equal to 90 degree, then the flux is 0 because cos 90 is 0. And if theta is equal to 180 degree, then flux is negative. And what is electric flux density? Electric flux density is electric flux per unit area. And electric flux is equal to eA cos 0 in case the electric field is towards the direction of area vector. So the result is eDA cos 0 equal to eA. And electric flux density equal to EA by A, that is equal to E. So you can understand that electric flux density and electric field both are dimensionally same, and we can say that electric flux density is a vector quantity whereas electric flux is a scalar quantity. What is the unit of electric flux? The unit of electric flux, one unit you are getting newton meter square per coulomb, another unit you are getting volt meter, and the dimensional formula of electric flux is ML3 T to the power minus 3 A to the power minus 1.